Cause I'm searching for that special place.
Hello everyone, it's Boom Bang Crash here. You can call me Crash for short. And we're back playing some Minecraft on the Crashland server. And I saw you, you little bugger. Where are you hiding? I hear ya. Yeah, you think you're gonna hide in here, huh? Take that! Oh, ouch. Okay, you're done. Let's close the door, man. Who's letting... What? Close the door, huh? Somehow I don't think that's gonna matter much. Anyways, we're back playing some Minecraft on the Crashland server. Check it out. We got ourselves a dragon head in the last episode. I actually picked up two. I went back and fought the dragon one more time. And went into the end city and, yeah, got a little few bits and pieces. And, yeah, what else did I do? Ooh, creeper. Creeper. Let's see. My bow skills have not been getting any better, so. Ho-cha. Ooh, where'd he go? Ooh-ah. Okay, die, creeper man. There we go. Ooh, what's happened since the last episode? Oh, we finished off the minecart here. Check this out. We're going to go for a little ride. Make sure it's all safe. Okay, all safe. Which one's first? Dispenser first. Chink, like that. Get in the cart. Hit the, push the button. And now we go. Yeehaw. All the way down to the bottom of our deep mine. I've since closed off the hole, and we're going to show you some cool stuff. And once we get down there, this is no longer broken. You can get all the way down in one motion. Although I did say I was going to make a station there. I'm not too sure if I'm going to anymore because I don't think I need to. Boom! Look at that! Check it out. So we've got ourselves a very simple station. Very, very, very easy. What happens here is there's a line of hoppers underneath here. There's a dispenser. You push the button. Boom. Triggers the dispenser. Dispenser pops the minecart up onto the rail. Push that button. Rail gets powered. See? Watch. Powered rail. Boom. Goes this way. This is a detector rail. Underneath is a piece of redstone connected to a block. Through the block, there's a torch. The torch changes, which changes the angle of the rail. So as you're coming down, it changes the rail so it faces that way. And then you run into the cactus, which is what destroys the minecart. So, yeah, it's pretty good. It works really well. I'm really happy with it. And down here, we've done some work. We, obviously, we did some detail work here. We kind of added words come to my face. Please come out of my lips. We added some detail to this face here. Obviously, we added some lava. Be very careful. Is there any wood here for this to burn down? No. And, yeah, it looks kind of cool. You know, just trying to get a little bit more moody. And, I don't know, things could probably spawn up there. We'll have to be careful. And we put the railway, instead of coming down here, I just blocked this off, finished it off to make it look a little bit better. And the rail runs between, or behind the skull, sorry, not the skull, the statue, kind of, the face. And then it comes down here into our minecart station. So this area is basically finished. I have a few little odds and ends to kind of clean up, some little details to do. Down here, we put in our beacon. We installed our beacon. So we've done some work. We've kind of extended the ceiling down here. We also kind of finished the ceiling out to match on both sides. So you can see we've put in these pillars here, and we put the pillars in over on that side. What? And yeah, I've been getting spawns. Yep. So here's our beacon. I really need to fix that texture. It's it was an experiment. I'm sorry, folks. Just don't look. Turn away. Look the other way. It's horrible. I know. And I did I did show that to you. I was going to show it to you, but then I canceled that part of the recording. Anyways, right up there is the cows next to the farm. I don't know if you guys remember that or not, but that's where that ends up. So, yeah. Anyways, I think for today, I really, really kind of want to get started on doing the lighthouse build. So I'm going to take you over. First of all, how do I do this? There it is. Boop. Give me that in there. And away we go. So if we're going to go take a look at... ooh, check out the gold. There's gold in that guy's brain. That's so cool. We're going to go up and we're going to head on over to the lighthouse build where I'm messing around with some different materials. And while we're before we get all the way over there, I'm going to cut to another little clip that kind of reveals some stuff we've been working on elsewhere. All right, so as promised, I want to give you a little bit of a preview of what I'm working on. Now, this is a work in progress. It is not complete. And yes, I'm in creative mode. It will be a survival multiplayer game, our server, sorry, not game, when we're done. But as you can see, we're just getting the spawn hub ready to go for a new server called Crashlandia. Now, this is going to be a fan server for anybody who wants to come join us, anybody who's a fan of the Crash channel, and you'll be welcome to join. In the beginning, there shouldn't be any requirements other than, I don't know yet, we'll have to discuss that, but I'm looking forward to building the community with you guys. And then later on, we'll probably set up a Patreon to cover the costs of the server, and then there'll be some basic access levels. But for now, I'm not looking, it's not about making money or anything like that, it's just really, if there's any charge for anything, it's just to cover costs. And yeah, so this is, like I said, the spawn room, and I went with this really kind of, I don't know, it's a different style for me, I've never done before, so I used a lot of quartz, I've used a lot of glass, and my whole philosophy here is that you basically spawn right here, so this is kind of ethereal concept that your consciousness is being downloaded into your Minecraft body, and then when you look this way, you'll see Welcome to Crashlandia, and then over here will be a list of rules and stuff like that. And then as you come up this way, you'll see, okay, head off to town, and this is the path of cleansing. So this is where you leave all of your stuff behind. You leave the real world, all the crap from the real world, and that stays in this room. It doesn't come with you. And then you walk down this path, and as you can see, I've kind of made this, well, it looks like a kind of a rain, like a glass rain. So it's kind of a bit of symbology to say, hey, welcome to the server, leave your outside crap at the door, and just bring your creative Minecraft awesomeness with you. And then over here, we'll give you, actually, let me just change the time here. Time set 0, and then we're going to lead over here. And so you're going to take this kind of epic journey across, and I'm going to do a little bit of building. I'm going to lay out the foundations of the spawn town, but this area is kind of what I was thinking. It's actually quite beautiful. We have a lot of variation in terrain, and it goes on here. We're in an extreme hills biome, and we've got some snow, but just beyond, we have this nice little plains, and we've got lots of trees. We've got lots and lots of different choices of biomes. There's a swamp right here, so I figure this is kind of a good place to get started, to get set up with what I'm hoping will be a really cool server. And then down here we have a spawn village as well, which is nice and handy to have. So there's some resources here. I don't know if we'll keep it or if we'll move the villagers into a redeveloped spawn town. That's right, I think we should do that, don't you? We'll give them some new luxurious digs, but we'll leave it for now so we have access to the villagers and anything they have close to home. And yeah, so I got a lot of terraforming work to do still. I got to get this all detailed out. You can see it's very plain right now. Got to finish the bridge off. So, and again, lay out the foundation for what will be the future. I'm going to probably lay out some road networks just to set the tone for what I want this area to be. And then after that, it's all going to be yours, guys. So yeah, anyways, look for an announcement video and with all the details about the server information and how to get access to it in an upcoming video. I'll do a little special that's just dedicated to it. Plus, we'll have a Discord server, which is I already have working right now. In fact, I don't know. Can I do that? Can I say hello? DCC, hello. Does that work? Yeah, it does. Sweet. There you go. So if I actually go into my Discord chat, you'll see it show up there. So you have two-way communication between Minecraft and Discord, and that will be the way we set up our community. I'm really excited. I've been working on it I've been working on the Discord channel for a while. And this, actually, I was so inspired. I did this in about an hour. Or maybe it was 2 hours. It wasn't that long. So lots to do still. Lots to finish off anyways. I hope you guys liked that tour. And well, let's get back to Crashlands. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that little preview of Crashlandia. I'm really excited to get it going. I'm working on just getting the server set up with some plugins that will help me manage it and any future moderators, and help to prevent some griefing. It will be the survival multiplayer server. I am doing creative right now just to get that spawn hub built up. I just want to have, you know, a really, really cool place for the players to come in. Plus, I'll be doing some terraforming, some other stuff. Anyways, we're back on Crashlands, as you can see by where we are. I just turned my mouse sensitivity down because I feel like I spin a little too much when I look back at my videos. So here's some ideas. Here's some colors. All right, so we've got this structure right here, which is going to be our lighthouse. And I don't know how tall it's going to be. Not sure if we want to make it super tall. Ooh, I guess we can check this out. Let's see if we can be a pro. Oh, did it hit it? Yes, we did it. Nice. Boof, like that. I gotta get used to this thing. Anyways, what I figure we'll do is if we look back here, we look at the height, I'll probably pull it up so it's not quite as tall as this. Well, maybe it will be, but it'll probably kind of bring it up here. And we'll put a kind of a narrow lighthouse right here. I'm thinking kind of old school blocky. I don't know. I'm trying to think. There's this place. Where is it? Oh, it's on the tip of my tongue. Anyways, it'll come back to me at some point. Oh, Alexandria, the port of Alexandria. I think I've seen some kind of fantasy looking art that has these really squat lighthouses. So I think that's what I'm going to do. Here's the palette. We've got clay. I'm going to try and use some of these wools, which I only had a little bit of. We're going to actually need to get some more. We've got some acacia wood. We've got some stained clays. Not sure about these yet. But I wanted to force myself to use some different colors. These all are complementary and all work together in some form or another. They're all in the same kind of basic tonal sense. I really want to use some acacia. I'm debating changing this texture, and I'm also debating changing the wool texture, but I'm going to get back to that. I think I want to get rid of this red wood, but I know it's acacia, but I feel like this would look really good. This log in particular would look really good if we could have this gray kind of be faded. So I don't know, I'm gonna have to figure that out. But this is what I'm gonna be working on for probably a couple episodes, or maybe just one, I don't know, it depends how long it takes. And we're gonna get started. I'm gonna go do some harvesting, grab some resources. We're gonna have to go stain up some clay and some wool and do some other stuff. I have a whole bunch of this clay, but the rest of this I'm going to need to go over to the Mesa biome and grab some more. So I will be back shortly, a few seconds for you guys and probably a few hours for me. Got a lot of light blue dye, that's right. Anyways, I've converted up, found some dandelion yellow. I guess there's two types of yellow, I didn't know that. And we've got some clay. Here's all the stuff we picked up, light gray, stained clay. We've got some light blue hardened clay, which I've already converted using this dye. Picked up some other blocks. I've got some cyan hardened clay, which we used. What was the recipe? It was cactus and some blue. So that's all taken care of. I've lost a few pieces of... No, I guess I only lost one piece of armor. That's right. I lost my helmet. Creeper blew up next to me and toasted my gear. So I really, 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 really need to get mending on my stuff. So anyways, I was looking at some photos, and at first I was looking at this kind of candy cane stripe, and I was thinking way too modern. I don't know what I was thinking. So I think what's going to happen is we're going to actually limit this, and we're going to limit, give me those blocks back. We're going to limit the palette. I think entirely. I did make some of this. I'm not sure we're going to use this now. Let's get rid of that. And I don't think we're going to use this color anymore. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick to these blocks. And I am actually probably not going to use the wool at all either. Chances are pretty good I'm not going to use the wool. So I got these chests here. Let's put this down into my building supplies. How about right here? Perfect. Get rid of all this stuff. So I'm going to get started. I'm going to lay out the foundation. I'm going to get a feel for it. And then I'll bring you guys kind of back into the fray once I have an idea. It's just going to take a little bit of hemming and hawing to kind of get started. Then once I have something I'm happy with, we'll bring you guys back. On second thought, I think we'll start together. I know I'm flip-floppy today. So, I think the base... We're going to want to have it be kind of coming out of the rocks for sure. So I think we're going to keep it natural down here. Let's see. Let's get rid of this, this, and this. And let's substitute in some schmooze stone. Oh, is that how it's going to be? Is that how this is going to work? Because I really don't think that's going to work for me. Let's get that in there. Ooh. Okay, so I think we'll get the smooth stone in here just to set the tone. And then, of course, I'm going to fall in the water. Man, I've been watching Etho's modded series right now, and I've been looking at that jetpack going, oh, some days, I super wish I could have that and just in regular non-modded. Okay, so let's say the floor in here is going to be made of stone. We can add a little bit of, what am I thinking? Oh, bricks later, but for now, we'll just keep that stone. And then here, I'm thinking we'll use a mix of stone and andesite. And boop, get up there. And this will kind of set the tone for this side. And then every once in a while, let's take a look at this. Let's take a look at that. Yeah. Okay, so this is going to be, I'm going to have to build this out a little bit more. I think what I want to do is raise this up. No, wrong block. Let's get that in there. It has to look like it's built. So I think, where am I going to have the foundation? If this was, this is a pretty flat piece of land. So I think we're going to have to put the foundation through here. So let's do that. I'm going to use andesite blocks for the foundation. I really like this block and it suits the theme of the town right now. And I can use andesite every once in a while to kind of show where it's worn out. So let me bring this all the way around like this, not like that. I am just placing blocks everywhere in the wrong spot. Yeah, it's actually, I was just going to say, it's the next day. I started filming this yesterday, but I had to do some real life work. That's right, it happens every once in a while, and it kept me pretty busy all day. I do, I'm a game developer, so I make games for a living, which is pretty cool, man. It's pretty fun. I'm actually working on a new game and a really cool IP, and excited to get that finished. Okay, let's take a look here. Okay. So if we make this kind of boxy all the way to the top, this will be like the foundation area. It's going to be so much like that though. I gotta find something else. I gotta find, maybe let's try some cyan clay. I don't want it to be the same as the other building. I'm a little worried about that. You know, I don't have any, okay, let's build pillar up with this one right now. I don't know. This is tough. I feel like I'm gonna build the same building I've already just built. So let's get rid of this one here, and let's bring this all the way up. We'll try out this style. Let's see what this is gonna look like. Ouch, ouchie mama. Okay, it's a thing. It could be a thing. But what would they would make it out of stone though? They would. It's just a simple truth. Oh, crash. Okay, let me mucky around with this for a little bit. Let me find something I like, because I'm not digging it. I'm just not digging it right now. Let me figure it out. Okay, let's see what I did here. It's a thing. I'm trying something different. I think I like to have this cobblestone on the inside. I'm really liking that. Now, I was just imagining something. So let me do something right here. Boop. Let me go all the way up here. I really need to get some dirt blocks. I really do. Actually, that's one too higher. Let's get rid of all this cobble. And let's just bring it all the way down. And, oh, you know what? I forgot one thing. Ouch. I forgot to get what I need the most right now, which is some of this stuff. Get some acacia wood. Let's get rid of that. Zombie flesh. So what I was thinking... Hi. Can I just fill this in? There we go. If I put some of this wood here, it's gray, right? See? Yeah, you see that. It's gray. And I'm thinking it offers another gray texture to complement the smoother stones and the andesite. So let's take a look here. Let's go this way. Let's use... Come on, Frostwalker boots. Do your thing. Thank you. Yeah. Okay. I'm liking that. Ooh, I gotta fix that there. Okay, so that adds a little bit of tonal differentiation, and it adds some wood texture to it, but it's not a dark wood or an oak wood, so I think... Okay, I like that. Ooh, as I fall through and freeze to death. So that's going to be a thing, I think. Let's... Nope. Oh, crap, it on my axe on me. Ugh, break it the long way. There we go. Put that. Oop, like that. Nice. Okay, so I'm going to do that. I'm going to build out this wall all the way around, and we're going to have a look at how that feels, and then I'll bring you guys... Hello. I'll bring you guys back when I've got this first floor kind of baseline decorated. Aha! I like it. I'm starting to like it. It's coming alive. So let's pop on down here again. Nope. Come on. Give me my boots. Thank you. And let's just walk around here. So I'm liking it a lot. I changed out the cobble on this side for andesite. You let me know what you think. I don't know. I feel like they're both really good. This might look a little better. I don't know. Maybe we'll mix them together. My only complaint now is really how flat this looks. I like these windows. I really do with the kind of inset like that. But I'm actually thinking we could take advantage of the cobblestone look. Let's just do this real quick. And I think I've got a couple pieces here with me. Let's get that and get that. So what if I just kind of broke, let's see here, which block? Let's break this one right here. Yeah, like that. Whoop. Nice. Yeah, yeah, see what, see that? I like that. Just a little bit of a kind of a crack, and maybe we do one right here. This one we can do upside. Oh, I like that, but I can't do it because you'll be able to see through. Let's just do it like that then. Yeah, yeah, I like that. That is going to make it, ooh, and I actually kind of like this dirt here too. This dirt will look kind of nice. Maybe we'll toss a little bit of dirt here and a little bit of dirt there. Break that, yep. Mm-hmm. And oh, I brought these out too because I'm thinking we need some height variation. Do some little detail work while we're out here. Let's see, right there maybe. Down there, one there, one there, there, a little dirt like that. Yeah, yeah, now we're talking business. And then a little stair action, like, no. Oh yeah, that's okay. What about right here? Like that. And maybe we put in a fence post there and there. No, I don't like that. It's getting crazy. Getting crazy, crazy talk. Ooh, let's get off of that before it breaks. Come on, glass. Come on, ice. Glass. I don't know. What do you think, guys? This is really too flat. I don't like it. I need to come up with some solution for that. But this is starting to look a little bit better with the terrain and the dirt. And that, I like that a lot. Got to be use that sparingly. So if we come back to this, can we mix in andesite? I think we can. Give me the andesite block. Where would it look good? How about we try right here? Like that? Okay. Yeah, that's a thing. How about we pull that one up there too? Hoop. Aha. And right there. And it feels like this might be a little too uniform. Let's take a look. Let's take a look. Give me some ice, baby. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I'm liking that. I'm liking that. I think that's going to look better. So it's definitely a little mix of everything. The cobblestone is kind of the main feature. So let's go back over here. And let's do the same thing over here. Let's break out that one. Let's break out that one and this one. And, oh, you know what we can do here, though? You remember how I was saying, oh, let's see what that looks like. I was saying how I couldn't, oh, yes. So this is going to make a non-uniform window. It's going to make it kind of look a little different. Ooh, I don't know if I like that. I think I do. I think I do. I think I do. Let's put that one there. And let's put in some, give me some cobblestone. That slab? No, give me a regular cobblestone brick. There we go. Boop, like that. And let's see, this one right here. Put one in there. And one more cobblestone right here. This one has a little less cobblestone overall, but that's okay. Let's see what that looks like. Yeah, 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 yeah. Okay. It looks like it's slightly used. Now, the other thing we could do is, I guess we... Oof. I want to reserve cash. Smooth stone on me. I do. Let's put that there. I guess if I pulled out that one there, maybe put some of this in, just a little bit of cobblestone smooth stone action, just to kind of break it up. Not too much. I still want to make it look like it's a pillar. Yeah. Okay. That's okay. That's not bad. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. What do you guys think? I got to be careful. Again, we're starting to drift into this look a little bit. The wood definitely separates it. I mean, they feel like they belong together. This is important. It's all part of the same kingdom. I do like that. But I want to make sure that we try to kind of stretch ourselves a little bit, kind of make things a little interesting. Let's actually put down some stuff here and maybe put that there. Let's take a look here. Pop two of those out and maybe put Oh, I didn't even think about that. We should do that too. Ooh. Yeah, 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 yeah. And then, no, I did that one already on the other side. Maybe this one doesn't have any cracks. They don't all have to have cracks, right? It's not like every wall is broken. Okay, that's one, two, three. Okay, that looks good. That's actually my favorite one so far. Maybe it's because it's got the smooth stone in there. I don't know. Okay, that is coming alive. We need some love here, though. Let's see. Let's put some... Oop, not there. And let's get some slabbage. I need the ice to freeze. Not the ice to freeze, sorry, I need the ice to go away. Let's get that out. And put that there. And some of the slabs over here. Yep. Yeah, okay. Man, it's amazing how much slabs, how... Really? Go away, rain. What are we gonna do for the inside? Let's see, let's get some smooth stone laid out. Need to get some more, I think. Let's get up here. Okay, I like the way this looks. Now, on the inside, I don't think I have any more, do I? No, I don't. On the inside, I'm thinking we're gonna go with a square. A square as opposed to a circular. We're gonna have a circular base, we're gonna have a square lighthouse portion. And I feel like we're getting close to the height I want it to be. I think this will be the base. Let's see, if we go, this is the corner. One, and then the next corner will be right here like this. Let's create a framework here. Let's see what looks good. Boop. And then that would be one, two, skip a few, put another pillar right here. You'll see what I'm thinking here in a second. Hopefully I have enough blocks for this. Yep. Okay, and then let's walk around over here. And, which way is this one? One there, two there, and it's right there, right? Yep. Okay. And we just have to build one more little tower. I guess I could just go like this. No, I can't. One out, one over. Oh, give it to me. And there, is that it? No, it's here. Why is it here? Okay, right here. Boop, boop, boop. And it's gonna get nighttime soon here. All right. Oh, the pain is suffering. Let's eat some food. Yum, 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 yum. Let's do this real quick before it gets dark. I have to find a bed again. Yeah, Oh, it's too small. Well, I guess we could put a roof on it, though, that would come out like this, an extra block. But that feels kind of wimpy, a little too wimpy. So I'm going to pull it back a block, maybe. We'll put it right here and right here, and that'll make it a little bit beefier. Okay, yeah. So I built this little framework, and I think that's probably going to be the height. I was just trying to work out the flames. I was trying to see what we could do. So I put some iron bars around, and I also grabbed some netherrack and a couple blocks of coal. I don't know, I think you can light coal on fire, I just don't know if it gets consumed. And let's put this here. Okay, come on now. Hello? Hello? Thank you. Oh, what's this? Oh, jeez. Break that. I was trying to decide how high I wanted this. I think I want to get, let's see, boop, 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 let's get this like this, break that. I'm thinking this should be the base level of the fire, so if we go like this, and if we grab, I got some obsidian as well, I just wanted to try out some different colors. Obsidian probably has too much, red in, or not red, sorry, kind of purpley in it, and break that. So let's just light this and let's get out of the way here. Let's see what happens. Yeah, okay, so it does spread. Ooh, I like that. Come on, get all the way over here. Spread all the way. There you, oh, it consumes it. Ah! Okay, well, that was an experiment. Oh, let's put that there. So, coal blocks we can't use, unfortunately. They will actually get consumed. That makes sense. I mean, sure, it makes a lot of sense, actually. Okay, well, that was, it was worth a try. It was worth a try. So I think we're gonna be stuck with netherrack then, and I'm gonna have to find an enclosure that's suitable because I really, spray that and that, and yeah, it's gonna burn out. I really want to have a big fire, like a really big fire. I guess one other thing I could try out. So I could try stair-stepping it. Oops, trying to burn ourselves. Oh, yeah, of course. Yes. Burn ourselves some more. There we go. Yeah, so to block that off, I guess I could put... Well, I can't put coal there. It's going to burn, but... Okay, let's get this here. And then let's see what this looks like. No. No. We're definitely going to have to put a block on the outside of there. Maybe we put, let's see, do I have any of these on me? I do. Maybe we put like that. Oh, shoot. Give me that back. Black coal. Why not? Give me that. Put that there. Where's my tool? Give me my flint. Oh, come on, Crash. Give it to me, baby. All right. Yeah, that'll work. I guess I could do this. But then I wouldn't be able to put the framer. Oh, you know, maybe this is just a bad idea. I was trying it out. I wanted to get some other elements in here. Maybe that just looks the best. Have a big... like this. Yeah. Okay, let's try this here. It would go all the way around and it would go connect in the corners like that. Well, I guess it doesn't need to connect in the corners. We can cut that out. Let's get rid of that piece. Okay, let's go check it out. Get rid of this coal block here. We're going to have to use our imagination just a little. Oh, wow. Just a little bit. Ouch. I need my ice, baby. Give me my ice. There you go. This has been a lifesaver, being able to walk on the water like that. Ooh. Yeah. I'm trying to think. We're a mariner. We're coming in. We've been at sea for months and months and months. We're tired. We're hungry. We're thirsty. We want, you know what we want. Ooh. Oh, I like that. I like that a lot. Hello, horsies. Which way am I going? This way. Yeah. Okay. It's a thing. It's a thing, folks. I love it. I love it. Okay. Let me think about the base a little bit and let me figure out the roof and yeah. Okay, so we're done. I'm gonna show you this in a sec. I'm gonna wait for the rain to fade, but while the rain's kinda doing this thing, I thought we'd just kinda build this little staircase. How are we gonna do this? Let's see, still got a block here. Ooh. That's not gonna work. I guess, can we put a slab there? We can. Oh, mind you, we're going to actually step down here, so that probably will work just fine. Let's grab that one there. And then this one. I never know the best way to do this. I guess it would be pull down a block like that? No, that's not going to work. Let's get rid of that. Let's see here. I want to come off here, so I guess if I go like that, and then I go like that, and then I break that, and then of course that's going to break. Ugh. Okay, and then we need to come off. Where's this one going to be? It's not going to be there. It's going to be here, and then we break that one. Oh, I think I figured it out. Finally. Go like that. Aha. And then down there. Nope, right there. And then here. Step down, break that. I have successfully figured out Minecraft. And like that. And then break this one. Oh, we so smart. Then it goes down. And then over there. And then like that. Oh, that's such an easy way to do it. I was doing it so backwards before. Now we can collect all these guys. So that's going to be our way up. And let's check this out. So we're going to step up here. And then we're going to spin around. And yeah, we'll put in some railings. I really like these spiral staircases. They work really well in compact zones. And let's just take a look. I think we can actually put that back. Yes, we can. Nice. Okay, so as we come up here, you can see I put some detailing in. It's really hard to see, but I got some railings and stuff. Can I scooch through here? I can. Let's jump down here. And let's go take a little spin skis. I'm sorry for the rain. It's just, it's raining. Can't do much about it right now, unfortunately. Let's go out back here. Nice. Actually, that helps with the lighting so you guys can see it. I'm liking it a lot, actually. It's turned out better than I hoped. It's unfortunately not as much in the way of using different materials, but once I actually picked the style of lighthouse I wanted, it just made more sense to do this the way it is now. And then also blends a little bit better. I still need to do something about this really flat face. If you guys have any ideas, maybe toss them in the comments down below. Anyways, on this very, very rainy end of the episode, I just want to say thank you so much. Oh, creeper! Run away! Ha ha! Sucker! Anyways, guys, you know what to do. If you like this video, make sure to bang on that like button down below, crash that subscribe button, And as always, I'd love to hear from you in the comments down below. My name is Crash, and I'm very wet. No, I'm out. Thank you.